Welcome to Shedpix International Television.
So, okay, Neil, what's this that you've got in front of you?
This is the dual fuel Bushwhacker.
Sorry, say that again. Careful.
The dual fuel Bushwhacker.
Dual fuels, that's diesel and glow, is it?
It's a glow and it's electric.
It's a what?
Electric. Would you like me to spell electric?
You haven't.
I certainly have.
Dear, dear, dear. These electro pervs are getting everywhere. So what's that then?
It's a 350 watt outrunner. I couldn't tell you the designation exactly. So it could be the whole load of the
approximately how much does that cost?
From BRC Hobbies, they sell for about £49, including the speed controller.
So it's not outrageous. It's roughly comparable to a 15, I suppose, is it?
Yes, like buying a 15 glow motor.
But in this case, you're sort of buying all your fuel that you're ever going to use at once, aren't you, because you buy your battery.
When you buy the battery. The battery is like buying all your fuel in one go.
Yeah, so what sort of battery is it?
The battery that's in there is a 2,500 milliamp flight power, which was £60.
Is this a LiPo?
It's a LiPo, yeah. Three series LiPo.
Two cell?
Three.
Three cell.
Three cell LiPo.
Okay. So can we just do a little look around the model? I mean, the first thing that I noticed straight away was that you seem to have the same lettering and you've done it in an arc. But you told me earlier, you told me on the phone that you didn't actually do that in the prescribed method by downloading it from the computer. You actually did it by low-tech methods.
Took it off the magazine.
Right. So like a photocopy?
Scanned it off the magazine.
All right.
Enlarged it to the size I wanted and then cut it out. So the logo is exactly your copyright.
We'll have to ask, because I borrowed it off the internet, the logo, didn't I? The dual fuel here, I'm bound to ask you, I can tell you that the physics bit's right, but the chemistry bit I can't do. Is that right?
According to Wikipedia.
Wikipedia.
Wikipedia says that is the correct formula for methanol.
Okay, well, can we just look a bit at it? I mean, are there any bits that you have to change because of electric that I wouldn't be aware of from my original plan?
Apart from a set of cooling holes.
I didn't notice that. It's a dorsal cooling.
Yep. Right. It's just let some of the warmth out from inside.
Yeah.
But the way in which it flies, you're not pressing the battery very hard anyway.
I noticed this straight away. This really heavy duty, but just bring it round. That looks very impressive, that stainless steel there.
It's alloy.
It's been polished, hasn't it? Somebody's polished that. That didn't come out the shop looking like that, did it?
No.
It's very nice. And big wheels make you look nice, don't they? And of course, they have another effect, don't they?
Easy takeoff and landing.
Yeah.
Very easy.
Yeah.
And it looks nice in the air. Looks very suitable.
No, I agree.
Suitably vintage.
Big wheels do look cool. So what's that at the back there? You've done something at the...
It's just a castering tail wheel.
Right.
Again, large diameter wheel, bit of a spring. It's just a straightforward, I think it's a slack item, to be honest.
That's cool. Casting tail. Also, I noticed that you've the fillet is much grounded. I couldn't make a fillet like you've made there. That fillet's a work of art, really. We can get it with the light so that we can see it.
Two pieces of triangular stock.
Oh, is it?
Yeah, it's two pieces of triangular stock, right. Basically.
I just wondered how you
just cut down.
I didn't want to ask.
Yeah.
The tear thick. That looks smashing. So the other obvious thing that anybody's going to notice as soon as they see it is it's not a two-channel or a single-channel model anymore,
no,
is it?
It's full house, ailerons.
Oh, I like this. Full house.
Full house.
Very good. Very good.
Enables it to do loops, rolls, stalls.
Well, it would have looped before, wouldn't it? But now we're talking about roll territory.
It'll do rolls now very, very easily. Split S's. Does the whole thing.
All right, reverses.
Spins nicely.
Does it spin nicely?
It does.
The rudder's big enough, is it?
I've enlarged the rudder from the original plan by taking it right down to the bottom and making it bigger.
I shouldn't be asking these thick questions of the design. I should know, but you see, I did spin it. It would spin, but the only way you'd spin it is to really stall it.
Right.
Really, really stall it, because it doesn't like stalling, does it? Exactly, it doesn't like it. Well, the other thing is, you've changed the dihedral, haven't you? Can we just...
Yes.
I mean, that it's just softened a bit, isn't it?
Taking about an inch out of the
dihedral. So. No, it's... it's just amusing for me to see, because I've only ever seen the ones that Mike and I have worked on, and the photos that people write into the magazines have sent me. I've not seen one in the flesh before. It's good. So how about flying? How have you got on with it flying?
Absolutely delightful. The battery that I've flown it on in the past was only generating about 125 watts. which isn't an awful lot of power. It's only about 50 watts per pound.
A few soldering irons.
And it flew adequately on that. The battery that's in it now, the flight power battery, the motor's capable of the full 350 watts, but I've not flown it on the flight power battery. So I should think the rate of climb will be startling, followed by long glides.
The glide is good with the glow version, isn't it?
Yes.
I mean, the heavyweight of the battery hasn't...
No, the glide with this, a 30-second engine run was giving about 3 or 4 minutes of gliding.
That's the way to do it, isn't it?
Yeah, so on the old battery, which was a 2,100 milliamp, I was getting 25-minute flights out of it.
Right. So, you did fly it with... You've got the other engine, haven't you? You flew it with a four-stroke.
I've flown it with the IC.
I see. Because I noticed you had the pod with you, yeah?
Yep.
Because that's the whole point, isn't it? You've used exactly the same method.
Same mounting.
The same mounting as the plan. And this time, the electric motor has a firewall.
Yep.
And they look like the real thing. They look like they're authentic resin-bonded paper, aren't they?
No.
Are they fiberglass?
No, it's an aluminium firewall.
You painted it?
The back plate.
Oh, this bit here.
That's off ply.
Ply?
It's just all ply painted. Yeah.
Well, this is lovely, the aluminium.
It is, isn't it?
And this is a pretty thing, I mean.
Yeah. So you just undo the four screws, that slips out with the speed controller.
And of course you've got a ball joint there, so that it's easy to pop it on and off.
Pops onto the ball joint on there.
The ball joint on there. I'll just try and point to this. Is that it?
Can you see it?
There's the ball joint.
I feel stuck.
So that the beauty about that is that you can flick it off dead easily.
Yes.
So hot swap, what's it take, hot swap between that and that?
About 5 minutes.
That'll do, won't it?
Yeah. All you do is you take the, undo the four screws out, slip this in, four screws, pop that on. The servo is live all the time, even in electric.
So in our club, where, for instance, because of planning controls, we can only fly... with power till 1 o'clock on a Sunday. When we want to fly after 1 o'clock on Sunday, you could just, while everybody's having a cup of tea and taking the cars out the gate, you can just swap this, and for the summer you can fly all afternoon. Well, you've almost converted me to electric.
The other thing for me is you can exhaust a battery and put the IC engine in while the battery's charging.
But not after one. Well, thanks very much, Neil.
Okay.
Thanks very much indeed. That's Neil with the electric Bushwhacker.